Good morning all, this is Arun. So I take care of the ServiceNow practices in Royal Cyber. So today's the topic of the day is removing the silos in the in IT with ServiceNow. So as we know, ServiceNow being a cloud platform, it provides the enterprise service management solutions which span across almost all the verticals of IT operations or IT service management, right? So operations management, application development, cloud offerings, automation, the event management, or come to say the day-to-day IT ops with respect to the core platform being ITSM, all the ticketing and tracking activities, report engine, all are part of the ServiceNow, for you can say the enterprise suite. And we have, we as RC as a ServiceNow, leaders, we provide our services or our capabilities, or we expand our capability across different plugins or aspects of ServiceNow, which span across all the topics which Jay discussed in the previous slide. So today we'll be focusing on how to bring a value add, or how to bring ServiceNow into our infrastructure to help help the client or help the team to eliminate the silos or eliminate the outages, and how we can add value to that infrastructure, right? So the main agenda for the day are to first to understand what are the different challenges the IT team face in a day-to-day basis, or more specific to the outage when it comes to an outage or incident management. Then how to eliminate the service outage with the help of ServiceNow as a platform and using its key modules. Then we'll go through a customer use case where we have done an implementation for the same, but due to security constraints, we won't be able to show you a live demo, but I'll be walking you through the idea behind the implementation and what we have done and how we were able to add value to the client. And then we'll discuss about the highlights of the entire session and we'll conclude. Then post that, we can move to the Q&A session. So any queries that you have, please park it till the end of the session, so that we can have an interrupted session and you can grasp as much as possible, and probably you can come up with your queries which we can address at the end. Moving ahead, let's address few real-time challenges which the IT team perform, like or IT team faces. Okay, so there are many, when it comes to our day-to-day operation, there are many challenges which the team faces. So let's address the major few of them. So first one is outage impact on business, right? So when you say outage, as we know, there's nothing but that is a downtime involved towards a solution or towards a service which is provided to the end user. That means the end user is the customer is not able to avail that service for a particular period of time, and that can be because of a hosted server going down, or maybe because of a network latency, or maybe because of some related incidents, or can be because of the patch, or can be of numerous reasons, right? So outage is always a major impact when it comes to business, not only just with respect to the time it takes to recover, but as well as the based on the criticality, it impacts majorly on the monetary part as well, right? So the more the downtime, the more the loss of money involved, correct? So then when adding to this, when the team is not able to respond to this such in outages fast enough, right? So every incident or every outage or anything happening in infrastructure, there is always a response time and there is a resolution time. When the team is not able to respond to such situations fast enough, that adds more towards the negative side of when it comes to we can say, which cause more time loss and more time to resolve the issue and bring the service back up and running. So initially, when everything was within a customer premises as a data center and other solutions or on an on-premises solution, so the data, which is data and information which is involved in such activities, were comparatively less compared to the current market trends, right? Since things are moving to cloud and cloud being more scalable and provides much more feasible solution in on a lesser cost, more and more system data and information are being generated and stored and being analyzed for numerous purposes, right? And understanding the data or getting the correct data out of it, then understanding it and then working on top of that, it becomes more and more not like the team is not able to it becomes more and more difficult in a day-to-day basis, because the data accumulates over a period of time to terabytes or more than that, right? And because of this, the team is one more major issue which the team faces is with respect to the correlation and prioritization, because they're not sure about which issue should be addressed first and what should be the priority. It can be all because of different reasons, right? Because when a particular, for example, when a particular server goes down, until the team comes to know that that server itself went down, so the monitoring tools and other stuff which is involved will say some service went down, there's some network latency, right? So understanding the root cause, prioritizing and correlating with the real-time scenario becomes harder in most of the time, which again adds to the negative side of the quadrant, because it takes more time for the team to understand, respond to it and resolve it, right? So what majorly the companies do in such situations are they inverse towards tools, especially towards the monitoring and log management tools, we can say, because and these tools are specific to a particular problem, right? For example, when it comes to a monitoring tool, what it does, it monitors the infrastructure or the service or the network devices and generates an alert whenever there is a whenever there is an issue which occurs in the infrastructure based on the rules or based on the threshold which is configured in these such tools, right? And then to manage the data, like since there's a lot of data which is being generated in every hour, to manage the logs or to make like generate a useful information out of all these generated system data, they invest towards tools for, again, when I say tools, it is more like standalone tools towards individual activities, right? So companies are ready to invest more towards this tools and skill set to avoid such situation. But the problem is, with more tools coming into picture, that adds more burden to the team, because they need to know how to operate all these tools and navigate between them, and making these tools communicate to one another becomes even more challenging, right? To integrate them and making sure the ETL is happening properly between them and making a foolproof solution out of it becomes even more critical, it becomes more and more difficult as well, right? Now let's consolidate all this all the major challenges the team faces into mainly three categories. One is with respect to service feasibility issues, which is nothing but the team is not sure about the complete infrastructure. They don't have the holistic view of the infrastructure, like how the entire infra is connected to one another, how the data transfer happened, which are the ports involved, or which are the service running in which server, right? They may be having an inventory list or something, but at the end of the day, until they know how these devices are communicating to one another, until they have the eagle view of the infrastructure, it's really difficult for them to visualize where the issue is happening and go and address it, right? Then second is the service availability issues, which is nothing but when the team doesn't know the root cause, or when they don't know what caused the downtime, right? What caused the service to go down, what caused an outage, they're unable to identify the issue on time and address it, right? Which again give way to the third issue, third category or third challenge, which is service resolution issues, which is with respect to they're not able to respond to it on time, and they're not able to resolve it on time, because basically they don't have any idea how to fix it, on which issue need to be fixed first. They don't know the priority, they're not able to prioritize and correlate the issues. All right, now we have spoke about like major, not all, but majorly the critical issues or the major issues the team face. Now let's say how to eliminate these issues, right? So before coming to that, we all know outage or incident are major impact to the infrastructure, and addressing it on time and staying within an SLA while keeping the team aware of the entire infrastructure, upskilling them and giving them the eagle view of the infrastructure and making sure all response and resolution are happening on time, right? It is very much critical in every infrastructure, but with the advance or with the market changing rapidly, the team is not able to keep the pace with the ever-changing technology, and with every day new and new tools coming into picture, they somewhere are not able to cope up with the changes, and that's where the major issue comes, right? Because all these tools are standalone and all these tools are working towards a specific task alone, and it's all again not talking to each other by default unless someone makes them talk to each other and make a solution out of it, right? Now when I say eliminate the service outage, and specifically using ServiceNow, as we know, ServiceNow being a cloud platform, the advantage is there is no on-premises solution, first of all, and ServiceNow provides the entire suite or entire ITSM and ITOM's capabilities under one roof, right? So when I say under one roof, the service management tools, which is nothing but the ITSM, again, drilling down a bit more, ITSM is nothing but the service catalog, the service desk operations, which involves the incident, problem, change, asset management, and right? That's nothing but the service management. And when I say infrastructure management, which is nothing but taking care of the inventory with respect to the like using the CMDB database, discovery and service mapping, the cloud management and the event management capabilities or modules of ServiceNow, and adding cherry to the cake is the orchestration capabilities, which is nothing but the automation and the AI. Again, orchestration is more into the automation area, and with the agent intelligence and the connect features of ServiceNow, we can add the AI capabilities as well, right? So when we have everything under one roof, it becomes really easy for the team to navigate as well as manage the complete infrastructure, because they don't have to navigate between different tools. They just need to know, have the understanding of ServiceNow, right? And ServiceNow being really a easy tool to understand, and since it is conquering the market, upskilling themselves with the knowledge of ServiceNow adds value to the team as well as to the client as well, right? Because they are able to understand the platform faster, and they are able to address the issues faster compared to the previous scenario which we spoke about, correct? Now, normally what happens in a scenario, in a situation, is the ITSM and the ITOM products are product acts individually, right? But when it comes to ServiceNow, when it is, like I said, the ITSM is the core platform of ServiceNow, and everything else is an additional plugin. So when you enable the required plugins like discovery or service mapping or orchestration or the event management, or matter of fact, any other plugin which is required, the effort involved in making these modules talk to each other is almost null, because it's there in the same platform, and it's already communicated with one another at the back end, right? All we have to do is to make some minor tweaks with respect to how we want these tools to communicate to one another, which is nothing but implementing the rules or the thresholds, right? And again, ServiceNow provides the UI based operation or the administrations, which eliminates the need of the team to know how the backend coding or how the backend configuration is happening, right? They can navigate through the UI and make the necessary configuration. So when we bring the complete infra into the CMDB of ServiceNow and tie it to ITSM, it becomes really easy to identify and manage alerts, and it becomes really easy for the team to correlate and prioritize the issues, right? We'll see how it is done, how it will happen in ServiceNow, right? So before that, let's see what is the key benefit. At the end of the day, when I say we can do all these things, we should know what is the key benefit that client gets out of it, right? The key benefits are: one, we can reduce the incident noise up to 99% in a sure shot, I can say, because what happens when a monitoring tool is generating an alert, there's a high chance of false alerts due to the latency in retrieving the data or retrieving the status from the infrastructure, right? So we have seen scenarios where for the same issue, there are multiple tickets being, or multiple incidents being generated, or sometimes false alerts being generated, right? So when we bring it under ServiceNow and using the ServiceNow capabilities like event management and orchestration and other modules, we can reduce the incident noise to 99% to make sure that we have the right information or right ticket being generated only when it's required, right? Which again adds to the savings part, because since there's a reduction in the incident noise, the team doesn't have to go through, they don't have to put that much effort in sorting through all the incident or all the tickets and finding out the actual one, right? Which in turn saves the effort, and they can reuse, or they can focus or use that effort into more productive productive actions in infrastructure, maybe with respect to upskilling themselves or towards more critical aspects of the infrastructure, which again gives savings towards the cost as well, right? Then, since like I said, everything comes under one platform, what happens? We have the historical data over a period of time, which adds the key benefits towards the predictive and proactive analysis, right? So we can with the historical data, we can, using the NLP or ML and other the other features, we can predict the possibility of an outage occurring again in the near future, and we can proactively address it, right? Which again as what is it, adds towards the effort and cost savings, right? Then once the alert is generated, the team has the insight towards the alert through the event management module, and the response time becomes really effective and it becomes really fast, and they are able to respond to such issues faster, and they'll be able to resolve it faster whenever there's a manual effort is required, right? And the key benefit is with the orchestration capability, we can automate the most common remedies, right? And once we have the automation in place, whenever an alert is generated, the first aids, right? So it can be anything. It can be just restarting the service, or it can be just clearing the buffer memory, or the what is that? Maybe the system is running out of enough memory space, so doing a cleanup operation, or it can be just to check the network, right? So doing a ping check, or doing a service alive check, right? The key or initial root cause analysis or the common remedies can be automated and implemented, which saves time, because the team doesn't have to do that again. And if the issue gets fixed using these common remedies, yes, that saves a lot of SLA time. And if at all the issue is not fixed, even after these common remedies or even after these solutions pitch in, the team exactly knows what all things happened, and they can focus on to the next step rather than starting from the scratch one by one, right? So that are the key benefits of having everything under one roof, or everything, bringing everything into ServiceNow platform. So how it happens, we tie the monitoring tool events to ServiceNow's event management events. And since ITSM is already there, so once the event management kicks in, the tickets are generated, and with the orchestration capabilities, we can tie the automation the common remedies, right? We can tie the automation applications or automation packages to this events, so that whenever such an event occurs, we'll see an example how it is. Such an event occurs, these solutions can pitch in and rectify the issue, correct? Now, I know this is more we spoke about how it happens, right? So let's see a user case, a customer use case, which we have done for one of the financial institute. So where we were focused on implementing the ServiceNow modules, which are performance analytics and reporting, via the software license management, orchestrations, like these are few example modules. And we were involved in creating and modifying the ServiceNow's existing modules, or creating new modules for them with respect to the drone, with respect to the CI relationship management, or the CMDB part, or CMDB data integrity and correctness reporting, correct? So we were involved in implementing these modules as well as enhancing these modules to fit for the customer's requirement. And what we majorly were focused on is we're improving the operational excellence by enhancing the monitoring and fault tolerance, and bringing everything into the service catalog. It becomes a one-stop ordering solutions for the team to towards their requests or service management. And service catalog development for, again, that's the one-stop ordering solution, right? So these are few areas which we focused on, and majorly one key solution which we provided them was with respect to the outage management using the ServiceNow's few major modules. One is the core platform, which is ITSM, then the CMDB and service map, CMDB discovery and service mapping, and the event management tool to for the initial phase. Then we added, we tied everything to the orchestration capabilities to bring in automation. Okay, so how exactly it happens, right? So again, I won't be able to show you a real-time scenario due to security constraints. So let's see how exactly it happens, correct? So when we say event management, what happens? On your right hand, on the right corner of the screen, you can see the color-coded dashboard, right? Which shows different tiles, which is nothing but different services, which are like, if you say green, that means it's all okay. If it's yellow or amber, it's major or critical, major or major issues. And if it is red, that means it's a critical issue, correct? So the event management module or event management capability of ServiceNow showcase the entire issues which is there in the infrastructure in more visual format. So the team can exactly pinpoint what all the critical issues are, critical issues are there in the infrastructure, and the size of the tiles denotes the priority or comparatively how critical it is, right? The bigger the tile size, that means that is more critical, correct? So they are able to categorize and prioritize these events faster, and they can address the major ones first, rather than just sorting through one by one and saying and understanding which one to address first, right? Which were, as we discussed earlier, which is one of the major issue which the team used to face when they were working with individual tools. Now, when I say event, again, this addresses the categorization and prioritization of the events. Now, how does the first issue, which is the visibility, service visibility issues, how we can address a service visibility issue? That's where the discovery in the service mapping capability of ServiceNow comes into picture. So what happens? Using the discovery module, we generate the CMDB or we make sure the asset management is happening, or we populate the CMDB database, and the service mapping provides the eagle view of the infrastructure. So you can see a sample or an example image on the left corner of the screen, right? Which shows how the servers or services are interconnected and how critical is it, and even the team can pinpoint to a particular server or service up to the service port level or service change level, saying that okay, this is where the exact issue is, or this is where I'm supposed to focus to resolve the outage, correct? So that visibility gives team more confidence towards addressing the issues, because now they know how the different entities talk to each other and where to focus first. So now the event management gives them the categorized and prioritized event to start with. And when they click on any of this tile, which directly take them to the corresponding ticket associated with it, and they can see the configuration item, the complete CIs involved in that particular scenario, and they can actually traverse through this complete map to understand how this particular issue is impacting the complete infrastructure, and they can actually correlate and understand when all this particular issue is impact, right? So let's take an example. Say there's an Apache service running in one of the server, and due to a change occurred, okay? So maybe somebody degraded the version of that particular service or particular, the package, right? Which call, like, which happened as per, maybe as part of a patch management, or which could be, which could have happened as part of a resolution for another incident, correct? So it happened, and that caused or that triggered a chain reaction in the infrastructure towards some other service going down, because which is dependent on this particular scenario. Somebody took the version from 1.2 to 1.1, right? So what happened? Some other service was depending upon the Apache service. So when the version degraded, what happened? That service become, the service got impacted, correct? What happens in a normal scenario, the monitoring tool will say the dependent service went down or is critical, but the tool won't say that there is there some changes happen at the Apache level, right? So the team usually will try to restart the service, try to do some initial bug fixes on that particular service level. But by the time they realize the issue is not there, the issue, the root cause is somewhere else, it there's a lot of time gap involved, right? So what happens with the service mapping is when such a change occurs, the historical data is there already with the team in the same platform, correct? And the service mapping module of ServiceNow exactly shows, highlights the CI where the issue is, rather than just saying that a particular service went down, correct? So that's what the correlation and prioritization part, which we spoke about earlier. So ServiceNow itself will show, okay, this is the area that you need to focus, because I have identified an issue at this particular point, correct? So when the team goes to the Apache service or the particular CI, it again redirects them to the CMDB, and with the historical data, they are clearly able to point out saying that there was a version change up happened. They can fix it, which will bring the complete infrastructure back to normal, right? The Apache service is now fixed, and the alert which was generated for the particular service also back to normal, and it's up and running, all right? So that saves a lot of time towards the resolution, as well as the productivity of the complete teams goes high. So now, let's say we want to implement it in an infrastructure, how to do it, correct? So in ServiceNow, like I said, the ITSM comes as the base platform, on top of which we need to enable a few plugins, which is the event management. We need to have the service map discovery and service mapping also available, and performance analytics also will add value, because we can actually see the real-time KPIs and what the reporting and dashboards using this performance analytics and the report engine of ServiceNow. And if you want to eliminate the manual effort involved in fixing such mundane task or such reoccurring incidents, we can use the orchestration capabilities to build custom applications or custom automation packages to do the common remediation, as we spoke earlier. So what happens? The event management will prioritize and categorize the events, which will be correlated with the service mapping and the CMDB database, which gives the team the entire view of the infra and faster access to the infrastructure to do a root cause analysis and fix it, right? And when the orchestration pitches, it can perform the initial bug fixes and the first aids to fix the issue. And if the package which is being triggered to fix this issue is not good enough, then the team can pitch in and they can put their effort in fixing it, right? And which again adds value to the team, because now we have a new issue identified. They can add it to the non-error database, right? We can add to the KB article, which is useful for the future reference, right? Because at the end of the day, we have the entire data under ServiceNow. We have the KB articles, we have the non-error database, we have the rules in place to prioritize and categorize events. So it's always a win-win situation for all, for the client as well, for the end user as well as for the team. So now, like I said, initially in a normal scenario, when we have single tools, what happens? Making them talk to one another becomes really tough. So here we don't have to do that, because we can reuse the connectors which is already available in ServiceNow for connecting to the monitoring tools to pull the events, or we can build our own custom connectors to do the job, right? And with the event rules, we can eliminate the noise, because they can convert or they can actually sort these all the incidents, and they can convert it into the event table, so which again populates as tiles in the event management dashboard. Now, once a CMDB database is populated using the discovery, the CA mapping is done automatically from the real-time inputs, and we can traverse through this in a topology based, or we can traverse through them on a pattern based correlation. Okay, and along with the pre-built rules, we can use our manual rules as well, and we can perform a semi-monitored learning, right? So when using the manual rules, we can again drill down to particular events, and when the team comes into picture to fix such issues, what happens? It adds to the learning part as well, right? And the alert actions on the incidents and the security part means on the actions to be performed on these incidents or alerts can be done by orchestration, which gives security as well, because there is no, because we are already automated the actions involved, so there is zero chances of human prone errors, right? And we can most 90% of the time, we can, using these automated remedies, we can fix the issue, correct? Now, like I said, using the performance analytics, we can identify the KPIs, and for the auditing purposes or in day-to-day operation activities, we can generate the reports, right? So these all things are happening under one umbrella, rather than the team traversing through different tools. So that adds a huge value to the team, because they can focus on one particular platform rather than going through different tools or skill set, correct? So again, there's no harm in understanding different tools, but when it comes to a customer or a real-time scenario, the faster that a team is able to identify the identify and rectify issues adds more value to the client as well as the customer, correct? So far, that's the part which we were focused on covering for the day. So let's go through the highlights of the complete session, which is once we tie the ITSM to the ITOM capabilities of ServiceNow, we can remove these silos where we can address the outages faster. When things are under one roof, it becomes service centric, and it gives a global access to the team, because it's no more an on-premises solution to provide a VPN to a particular team to access the infra, right? So become a service centric and cloud platform. ServiceNow being a cloud platform, it's globally accessible. And when we combine it with the latest tools like automation and AI, it gives the team gets or the client gets best out of each of it, right? Each technology, because they now have a foolproof solution in place, and they have the continuous learning also available. They have the historical data, they have the common remedies being automated, which again helps the team to redirect their spare effort or redirect their effort into more critical areas of infrastructure management, right? So that covers the almost the main agenda for the day.
All right, so thanks everyone again for joining this webinar, and thank you so much again, and you have a rest of the day, wonderful day. Goodbye.
Yeah.